Right now I'm just using an ultramarine blue to create the shadows of the shirt. Ultramarine blue is a really dark blue that creates a really nice shadow color for a much brighter blue. So okay, let's work on the. Now, whenever I'm painting, I'm always looking at my reference photo. I know you can't really see my reference photo, but I have it here. The actual photo, I had to condense the cowboy down a little bit because I wouldn't have been able to get the, he's a little bit taller in the actual photo. So I had to condense it, him down, will make him a little bit shorter so I'd be able to get the entire horse in there as well as the cowboy. So he's a little bit shorter than the actual photo. You just gotta decide which is the most important part of the picture you want. Plus I made his jacket a little brighter to make it stand out more, which I think looks cool. And also made the skin a little more weathered, made him a little bit older. I figure that looks more unique. Also, whenever you're painting the jacket and the actual photo, you can't see the sunset back there. I add the sunset, so the sleeve that's closest to the sunset is going to be brightest. So I start out with yellow. The further you go around the sleeve, you make it redder. So basically you go from yellow, and then I make it add more orange until you get a dark red, and at the very bottom you make it a reddish brown. And then there's parts where you add a little bit of what's called Indian yellow, which is a very orange yellow. But basically, then on the back side right here, you add a little bit of yellow too, because there will be a reflected shadow on the back, and it would stop right about here, because the back of his jacket will be shadowed right here, so you won't see as much shadow, or you won't see much highlight on this side of the jacket. You also put a little bit of highlight on the hat right here, and on that side. This would be the shadow side, so you leave it darker, very little yellow. Basically, I added a really yellowish brown, which basically is done by adding a small amount of red to the yellow. That will create the brown look. Let's see. So that's, like I say, I do have to, the entire time I'm painting, I'm constantly looking at my reference photo. I'm looking to see where the saddle lines up with the eyes. And like I say, you don't have to be exact, but you know, like I said, I did make the cowboy shorter in the actual painting. So it's not gonna be the same as it is in the photo, but you want a somewhat resemblance. So his saddle comes right there to by his face. The hand, you know, comes in relation to the saddle, and you constantly notice where you're looking. You also create the shadow, I forgot to mention this, on the skin. For Caucasian skin, I use a mixture of what's called quinacridone orange, burnt orange, quinacridone burnt orange mixed with titanium white. Makes a really good Caucasian skin color. You can also achieve the same effect, but here's, I'll show you, this is quinacridone burnt orange. That's what I used to create the skin tone for the cowboy. But you can also reach an effect similar to that if you use a alizarin crimson mixed with a light green. I know some people that do that. I don't have real good results from that. I'd rather use the quinacridone burnt orange. So, all right, let's get some of the shirt finished. I'm working on editing. I'm still trying to figure that out. So what I'll do is I'll videotape some of the what I'm doing here and teach you some of what I'm doing. I'll just stop the video, and then I'll just have to start up again whenever I'm ready. Hopefully I'll be getting some video editing software soon, and I can, that way I'll be able to do a continuous lesson without having to stop. Now this is, it's called Cerulean Blue. I have it mixed with a titanium white, which is a very opaque white. I'm sorry, no, this is zinc white. Zinc white's a transparent white. Titanium white is right here mixed with the cerulean blue. Titanium white is very opaque. If you, anytime you put titanium white over another color, you won't be able to see the color underneath it, which I kind of wanted on the highlight right here because I wanted that to be the highlight of his collar. Right here, it's not as, you kind of want the area underneath the that you're painting on top to be visible, so you don't want to cover up all the blue underneath. So just kind of create a neat look. I do the under, basically just the mask tone of the shirt first. And afterwards, I add in the details of the pocket. Let's see. Still need a little more. I'm gonna get a bigger brush. So, like I said, you gotta make sure you keep these in water. If you don't, they'll dry out. There, the bigger brush works better. Let's see how far does that shadow go down? Okay, I'm gonna create the white all the way up there. You always go from the back to the front as much as possible because that way you don't have to paint over stuff. So I'm gonna paint the shirt, then I'll paint, finish up the area around the shirt, the jacket, and then I'll finish up the zipper to his jacket last. Go layer by layer until you get the color you want. Like I said, it doesn't happen right away sometimes. You just gotta keep on messing with it until you have the right hue that you want. Okay, looks about right. Yeah, that's better. Should have started with a big brush to begin with. Normally you start out with the biggest brush whenever you first start your painting, and the further you go along you get smaller and smaller. And I was doing detail work and I forgot to change brushes because this is more of a mass part of the painting as opposed to a detail part, so it's better to use a bigger brush for that. There, it looks better. Let that dry a little bit. Back to a small brush. I'm working some of the detail around the jacket. Nothing's going to affect the nothing's going to be close to the shirt because I still want to, I still want to have the blue is going to butt right up to the jacket, so you want to be able to paint the jacket over it. So I'm not going to get a lot of detail right there, but I am going to. See, that paint's still a little bit wet. Let it dry a little bit more. I'm going to do this stripe that's going down the cowboy's jacket. I put where it was earlier, but I need to make it a little more distinct. So what I'm going to do is take a burnt umber light, which, and this is a liquid version of the burnt umber light, which is, works good for thin lines. The paint I was using here is heavy body, which is extremely thick, and it doesn't work as well for details, unless it's a really big painting, but it works good for covering smart large areas, but you just can't get really fine details with it. So first you shake this up like this, mix up the paint, and I just take a small amount, I mean just a drop, because this stuff's expensive. So I put one drop out, and if you need more, you add more. I know some people put a bunch out at once, but I don't like to waste paint, so I conserve. Okay, I'm going to go right down the skinniest brush I can find, because you want to be able to get that thin line. Sometimes my hand shakes, so I hold my elbow like this, so I don't have to worry about messing up on the painting. That's one thing I don't like about this easel. You can't, it has a lip that goes over. Now, you can't see the, if you put it out like this, you can't see the entire painting. And that drives me crazy. I'm gonna cut that part off here pretty soon. Okay, put that in there, lightly touch the blue part. Let's see, your hands are going to get messy. It's a pain when you're flossing, because I floss my teeth every night and my hands look like this, so it drives me crazy, but I don't like flossing with hands like that, so I make sure they're clean. Okay, now I'm going to work on the details of the jacket. So I'm going to take ultramarine blue, which is the darker color to the cerulean blue. Cerulean blue is the bright blue. Ultramarine blue is the darker, has more red in it. So add a little bit of white in here. Don't want to be overwhelming. I'm going to use some zinc white, which is a transparent white. The one I was putting down first. Actually, this is zinc too. I put down zinc white first too. So basically this is enable you to see each layer of color underneath it. If I put the transparent or the opaque white, which will be titanium white, over that blue, you wouldn't be able to see the blue underneath it. So I'm going to take a small amount of the zinc white, mix it in here, create, you need to just make subtle highlights, because it's not this, the shirt is still underneath the jacket, so it won't have a lot of really bright highlights. It'll be really subtle. If the jacket was on him and the sun would be on that shirt, you would have more distinct highlights. But since it's not, the highlights would be more subtle. So you put layer upon layer till you get the look you want. If you do it all at once and then you have it too dark, then you gotta start all over. So it's much better to take your time, do a little bit of layer by a little bit of layer until you get the look you want. No rush. Yes, I'm using a smaller brush too because I don't want to create large areas of this highlight. Highlight's meant to be used sparingly. Just like I don't put yellow, the brightest yellow all over the jacket. I use a little bit there and then up there on this hat. And then on the back side of this jacket, I put the yellow too. You wouldn't want that yellow everywhere because it would be too much. Same thing with this. The highlight of the shirt, even though it's subtle, you need to have it there somewhat, but it needs to be sparingly. You don't want to, that's why I'm not using a big brush for this. I'm going to get a camera that will show me mixing the paint and my palette. I don't have that right now. Once I do, then you can see the colors as I'm actually mixing them, which would be beneficial. I just don't have the equipment just yet. When you're creating a shadow color, I use what's called a complementary color, which I'll show you. This right here is a color wheel. If you look, you got the I'll do a video on the color wheel here pretty soon, but I'll show you this for right now. At the top, you got the yellow, you got red, and you got blue. Those are the three primaries. Colors that are directly across from the color wheel, take for instance yellow, the color directly across from it will be violet. If you mix those two colors together, it will gray out. So the yellow for his jacket, to make the shadow color, I mixed a violet with it, and that created the shadow color. Same thing with red. If you want to make a red darker, you mix it with green, and that makes it darker. With blue, you mix it with orange. So now if you keep those two colors separate, take for instance the yellow and the violet, you keep them separate from one another, it will create a contrast, especially if you put them side by side. So take for instance, if you put the yellow and the purple side by side, the painting, take for instance, here you go, they got the orange and the blue. They're complementary colors for one another. Side by side, it makes them stand out. Part of the sunset, you got the yellow, and there's really, and that's kind of a purplish blue right there. It makes it stand out. And the red, we don't have too much red and green in here. But that's usually why you look at, like, University of Florida, their uniforms are the blue and the orange, that's why they stand out so much, because they're complementary colors. Same thing with red and green for Christmas. The complementary colors make the Christmas colors really stand out. So I'm not sure if that's boring to you or not. I think that's neat. But. Okay. Do this pocket. Get some more paint. So I'm using the ultramarine, the liquid version, because I need to be able to do the lines. Use a thick body with this, you're not going to be able to get the same lines as you do with the liquid. Like I said, I just small amount. I just put a drop out. If you want more, you can add more. So it's better to save your money, and that way you can buy more paint whenever you need it, as opposed to just wasting it. Okay, I'm not going to draw. He's got a pen in his pocket. I'm going to leave that out. But I am going to paint the pocket. Okay. I also get a camera that will show my reference photo too. I don't have all this right now, but at least this would be something you can watch and try to duplicate at home. Like I said, you don't have to copy me exactly. I'm just showing you techniques. You know, you need to be your own artist. There's no need to try to copy me exactly. Just the important thing is to do it and have fun. And realize that you know, if you mess up, it's not the end of the world, and just start over again. So until you get it right. Okay, I'm gonna do the. He's got the decoration on his pocket. Goes down like this.